kani gadega patisi tv bat phidang pet yaki khubor baman kasngi
ka national youth president jong ka sengsan parthai ka national people's party ne ka npp ka badang susha ajet thmai ka banna ka jala manipur ka ratika yumnam kala ong ba ka npp kalong ka seng ka blai luot bat kamdei ka seng ka basha panya hakiwei pat ki sengsan parthai jong kari india habajba bi ki jingkeli hakabei dei bat ka jingis nokti jong ka ne ka party bat ka bjp ka ratika yumnam kala ong ba ka jingete along ka dei da ka wei pat kar kom henre ka npp hi hakajing sisha kalong ka batrei lai luot marwei
we take great pleasure welcoming our newly appointed National Youth President, Ms. Ratika Yumna. We take pleasure as the Meghalaya State NPP unit in having Ms. Ratika come to Meghalaya on her maiden visit after being appointed as the National Youth President. We have a lot of faith in her abilities. We look forward for our NPP youth in the state of Meghalaya to be really enthused, motivated and inspired by her leadership and to come up and organize the party with enthusiasm and with dedication. And once again, thank you very much, Ms. Ratika. Despite your very busy schedule, you've made it a point to come to our state and to meet our youth workers. As you all know, Ms. Ratika has a very, very illustrious background, and I don't need to elaborate because you all know about it. And we believe that this will really, really help the youth of Meghalaya to look up to Ms. Ratika. All the qualities of Ms. Ratika put together, we see her as a person who represents the very word, the very notion of empowerment. This is something that we want to show to our youth here, that the NPP believes in the empowered youth. So she is the very, very representation of that. So thank you, ma'am, for being here. And we look forward to a very, very productive meetings with the youth of the NPP in our state.
To be very honest, I basically come from an activist background, and I've been working a lot on issues related to indigenous rights and things like that. And one thing I really like about NPP is that it believes in having informed decisions and actually reaching out to the grassroots people. And when back in Manipur also, there has been a lot of like engagement in terms of how the people from the grassroots have been facing situations with the earlier governments and now. So the fact that NPP believes in empowering the youth and giving me an opportunity to take this forward is really, really heartening for me. And I would thank NPP for giving this opportunity to actually work on this.
Hakawai pat kalyang MLA ka NPP na Dadangre constituency na Rilom Garo u James P Sangma ulong ba ka jingkala kan dan ba ja kan kjala ha ka election man wan par ka NPP kan dei ka wei nei na ki seng sain parthai ka bansale ya kam ka bakong san na lor ka ne ulong ro ba ka seng congress kalama sibon ki jing e bat ka jing sakren na mar kam sem la trei ya kam kom ba ka lukular kom ta na kalyang ka NPP ka jing khang ka play back ya uno no u badan ya ka jing thmu ba ba ban trei na ka banta ka jala what kari hi brok away.
James, you have recently suffered a jolt in Vijayanagar, whereas around 400 to 500 supporters of your party have joined Congress.
See, these are all political gimmicks right now. We all know, when elections are near, you have 50 supporters of the NPP joining the UDP, something like that came up in Songsat. These are all political gimmickry. You have, Deborah Marak, who is a minister in the government, making a very irresponsible statement that Marcus Marak and Jonathan Sangma have joined her and are, supporting her. I think as leaders, it's very important to first verify the facts and then come out with any kind of statement. And then, because we see that just yesterday or today in the papers, she has backtracked and said that no, it's not Marcus and Jonathan, it's just their followers. So whether it's even Jonathan and Marcus, or even for that matter, these 500 so-called supporters of Joy, I think going by the way that she keeps flip-flopping and backtracking her statements, there is, you know, very less truth in that. It's just political gimmickry.
Hakabede parbaka khobor bo mantri rangba gajalla u Dr Mukul Sangma unsay khon naki artli ki constituency hak election MLA banwan kata kawaina ampati bat na songsang nakaliang GM Sangma ul ang bakani karai jong Dr Mukul Sangma kadai namar ba udan kajing artatien bar kajing ting yo unsha remno hakawaina kini ki constituency.
I think it's very unfair on the people of say Songsang, because in all probability he is going to contest from both, and he has to resign if he wins, you know, hypothetically, if he wins in one constituency, then he, in both constituencies, he will have to relinquish one of them. So I think it's very unfair to take people for a ride. This is very unfortunate, and this is being done at the expense of the state exchequer, because if you're contesting in two, there will be a by-election later on if he wins again. So it's a mockery of, you know, all he's been talking about fiscal measures to ensure that, you know, we strengthen our economy. So it's a total mockery of that, and also a mockery of the system of democracy by contesting in two seats. And thirdly, I think that he is scared. He's scared of losing in one. So this is sort of a insurance scheme here, where even if he fails in one, he can win in the other. So insecurity.
Hakani ke jingi kendo bar kinong pathai khobor bat kinong ilam jongka NPP hakani ke nong ba Shillong kinong pathai khobor kilasim kaburu ban keli yo jem sangma halor ke jingsa kem jingi breo ki bran kti hak ba thok pisa ya ki breo hakari Amerika leng ba ka fon namar badan na pedeng ki bla sha kem ki de ki betrei kam hak call center ke bala penya hak yeng wai ke bala long try da ke long yeng jong jem sangma.
This is a matter of an ongoing investigation. I don't think we should bring any names into this, because I think it's very wrong to bring out somebody's name while the investigation is going on, especially of a person who is a public figure and a public leader. This is also, I think, a matter of privilege, because you can't just bring in somebody's name in an investigation, which is a criminal investigation. I think so. I have no comments to make about that right now. But I'm very, very sure that SS Netcom, which is the company which has rented out its premises to this said firm, after verifying, you know, whether they have the proper documentation in terms of, you know, be it the headman's, certificate, be it a certificate from the additional SP of Shillong. After all these documents were verified and found to be true, then only SS Netcom has rented out its premises. So, yes, fine. I mean, if SS Netcom is by virtue of renting out its premises involved, then very much SS Netcom is cooperating in the investigation, and they are extending all possible help to the investigating agency. So I have no comments to make about that. Let the investigations continue. I think everyone is cooperating completely, so there is nothing to comment on that. If, as a layman, I'd like to speak as a layman, there is a due process, you know. So as a due process, when you have verified that all the documents are in place, you know, Meghalaya police themselves have given a certificate certifying that this person, has this necessary credentials and whatever, naturally, yes, we have rented out our premises. How much can we go into depth into who this person is and where does he come from? All the verification has been done, be it the headman's certificate, be it the police. So yes, we have given it out on rent to the premises to this concerned firm. After that, what they have done is very unfortunate. And the investigations are on, and I hope that the guilty are brought to book. But then we, as people who have rented out these premises, SS Netcom has rented out these premises, we have nothing to say about that.